Halo Sobat Ika, kembali lagi di vlog kami yang bernama Tech Think Tank. Sekarang kita sudah bersama dengan Alex dari Denodo. Dia merupakan Senior Director Asia Pacific untuk development Denodo dan akan berbicara lebih tentang data virtualization. Apa sih itu data virtualization? Let's talk with Alex. Hi Alex.
Hi, hello.
So, we can start to find out what is data virtualization.
Okay. Hello everyone. And thanks for having me here today. So, what you said, a lot of people might be wondering, what is actually data virtualization? Data virtualization is probably one of the most modern technologies for data integration and data management. With data integration, you can integrate data from basically any source, being it more traditional data sources like SQL database, enterprise applications. But data virtualization is especially relevant when we're talking about big data, when we're talking about IoT data, streaming data, social media data. Data virtualization is very efficient and effective to bring these different forms of data together, no matter if this data is stored on-premise or in the cloud or in any kind of third data storages as well. You may not have heard so much about data virtualization yet, so the concept of data virtualization is actually quite long in the market, and a company like Denodo has been in that space already for the last 20 years. If you're talking to somebody like a Gartner as an analyst, they will tell you that data virtualization is actually a very mature technology already. There's lots of customers with used or with successful use cases, and it's low risk to implement. Denodo as a company has actually over 500 successful customers worldwide using our technology.
So, tadi kita dengar dari data virtualization itu, that the latest data technology and data management in the globe. Jadi, apa sih bedanya? So, how is DV different?
Okay, that's a very good question. And so, if you're looking at the more traditional data sources, you typically replicate data. At Denodo and with data virtualization, we do not replicate data. We leave the data where we believe it's supposed to be, which is at the data source. Particularly when we're talking about big data, it's complicated or sometimes simply not feasible anymore to copy data from one place to another to another. It's not very effective, it's not very agile. So we leave data, first of all, where it is, we leave it at the source. At the same time, as we are accessing data only when it is required for the data consumer, means that we have real-time access for data. In a world where business is moving faster and faster, it's important to take the most timely decisions with the most timely information that is available. So real-time data is going to be very helpful to take the right business decisions at the right time. Another important part that a lot of our customers like is really that you are creating a central point for data access. So once you have a central point for data access, you can manage your data governance and data security in one place as well, which again is a great way to have a centralized place and an efficient and effective way to monitor and control data access.
Interesting. It's the value that you can bring to the initial market. But just curious about how big is the market it is. Yeah. How big is the market demand for DV actually, yeah, that you know?
So data virtualization is a market that is extremely fast growing, particularly in the last 5 years. Gartner has just publicized a market size report, and there they are saying that by 2022, 60% of companies worldwide will be using data virtualization as an integration technology.